Hello, welcome back. Thanks for joining me today. So we are going to make this file folder folio. And if you've seen my Thrifty Thursdays, you know I picked up a big giant box of these and I just need to use them up. So let me show you what I did here. I have a button closure. And lots of pockets, some journaling space, and some flip downs, and we'll dig right in. So as you know, as most of you know, I'm moving, so I'm limited on what I have, and that's why I used a button closure. My crocodile and eyelets are all packed up. So the same with my cutter is packed up. So the first thing that I did is I cut this off. Oh, come on. Doesn't want to cut. There we go. I should be using my cutting mat, but it's smaller. We're just going to cut the rest of that. There we go. You might want to keep these in case you need them for any decorating that you're doing. All right. So here's our base. And I made a little spine. First, we need to fold it in three and figure out how we want that. So about like that works for me. It's a couple of inches, probably about 2 inches there. That 2 3/4. So there's that, and before I make this spine, I'm going to cut this down. I don't want it this large, so I'm going to cut it down some. Right now, it's at almost 12, and I think this one I did 9. Yep. So, I'm going to do about 9. Do any size that you want it to be. I mean, it can be a great insert in a journal. Actually, I didn't need to do that, did I? I don't plan on using the scissors. Might go better if I use the mat, huh? I think my knife is dull. And keep that. You might need that. All right, we're done with the cutting. Those great little mats from Dollar Tree are awesome. So then I made my spine. You want to score, I did probably an 1/8 of an inch. No, 1/4 of an inch. I don't know what I'm saying. So it's 1/4 of an inch because you only need a small one. Did you see that? It broke. Cheap Dollar Tree tools. Both ends just broke on me. Hold that up to get a good crease. And there, now we have that. Awesome. So I'm gonna cover the outside of this. And let's pick papers. I probably should have done that beforehand, but I do have them all right here. I am using papers from, oh my gosh, I'm drawing a blank. Why does that always happen on film? Oh my gosh. I cannot believe that. Bohemian Crafting. I'm one of her Patreons. And so that's where all of the, I guess I should show you. That's where all of these came from. She does have an Etsy shop, and I'll link her YouTube channel and her Etsy shop below. And look at these papers. Aren't these just gorgeous? I printed out way more than I'm going to use. But this is her rose kit, and I believe it's her one and only rose kit. But don't hold me to that. And I don't know what she has in her Etsy shop. I haven't been there. I don't go to her Etsy shop. That would cut that off. But her Patreon is awesome. She has videos and lots of freebies. I'm going to ink this up before I do anything, because I will have parts of it showing. Sorry you have to watch me, but grab a file folder and join me. It's super simple, and you can decorate it and do whatever you want. And it's a great little thing to give, again, for Happy Meal, mail, pen pals, swaps. Put a few things in there and you're good to go. Everyone's doing great and getting some crafting in. All right, so now I want to get it a little farther in. And I do it separately because I like inking the edges. I like the effect that I get on the edges. If I didn't ink the edges like I just did a minute ago, then it wouldn't be so pronounced. I don't think. Not for me. I like you know, the vintage old world look. See the difference? Big difference. And I'm using Vintage Photo. So yeah, I really like Eva at Bohemian Crafting. I really like her style. So you definitely need to go check out her YouTube channel. She is very rustic, and that's why I say I think this is her only rose kit. Because she does everything, you know, more of a vintage. All right, and I want to get down the spine. Yeah, if you made them smaller, it would be even better for swaps and that sort of thing, I guess. All right, let's clean this mess up. Baby wipe to the rescue. Look at all the cuts I have in here. Because I'm not using that little mat. I think it's this paper. So like I said, I want a little bit of a border around. Hopefully that's straight. And since my cutters are all packed, we will attempt to cut a straight line. And I'm using Art Glitter Glue. I'm also going to stitch this. Coming along at the house. He's still putting up fence. He had to get more posts for the fence. And, you know, pressure treated ones are only sold at Lowe's. Home Depot doesn't have them. And our Lowe's didn't have any. And they said that they won't be getting any until January. Yes, January. Can you believe that? I don't. But either way, we had to go, or my husband had to go to a different Lowe's. Oh, look. Perfect fit. Nope, it's not a perfect fit. So, yeah, so he went and did that yesterday. I think he's making a dump run today. But but the house is slowly getting done. We need help. You can barely see the pencil marks. I don't know why I'm wasting time on it. I'm sorry. Yeah, today I'm supposed to be going through a bunch of stuff to see what I'm going to keep and what I'm going to sell or donate. I collect milk glass and I honestly have way too much, and I want the new house to not have a cluttered look, so I have to part with a lot of milk glass, and I mean a lot, and that is going to be super hard to do. So I'm supposed to be going through all these boxes today and going to the new house to bag up more leaves. But you see what I'm doing. Not what I'm supposed to be. Let's use this piece. I could have ran the whole thing, but I didn't want to. I want to separate them to give more of a finished look. I'm trying to get this straight. I didn't make a top mark. Nope, not straight. Definitely not straight. Hopefully I did cut it straight though. Nope. Nope. There's lines on here. Following them. Hopefully that's perfect, almost. How is that not straight? All right, let's put it down. Oh, and you know what I didn't do? I didn't ink these pages. I wanted to ink these too. You know, I really don't like this little bottle. It doesn't put enough out. I almost can't see the inking. Now I need more glue. Am I a mess today or what? I have so much to do, and I think that's why I got all of that on my mind. Alright, the outside's done. And it would have looked awesome if I inked. Yeah, tomorrow I'm planning a day trip to go see my mama. I call her that. She is a very dear friend who calls me her southern daughter. She's from Connecticut. And yeah, it's So I'm planning a day trip to see her tomorrow. Alright, so there's the outside. Let's figure out the inside and then do a little stitching. It's a shame that won't fit anywhere. I have all these offcuts with no place to use them. And I think this is my last piece. No way. Really? Alright, let's put that there. I think I'm short a piece. I'm using cardstock to make it sturdier. But you don't have to. I thought about using the paper since I printed off so many sheets. Maybe we'll use the paper on the inside since I'm short a sheet. This would be pretty on the flap with all the roses, so let's do that one. Let's do that there. You'll have to watch me cut this little white border off. So I have two printers, two HP printers. One of them is on the Insta Ink program. And it's giving me a problem. The rollers aren't wanting to work. And then my other one is just an older one. But I don't know. I want a new printer that works great and does what it's supposed to do. This is such pretty paper, isn't it? I should have a ruler with a little level bubble on it. I don't know if me eyeballing it's such a good idea. I miss my grid mat. Yes, I do. And my cutter, that's for sure. It's gonna be like Christmas when I unpack, when I move and unpack. And for all of you that watch my Thrifty Thursdays, I'll be putting together packets, too. It was once suggested to me, and I realized I have so much and I get so much. I'm addicted to the shopping, to getting those deals. Well, Holly had a concert, a chorus concert last night. The last one of the school year. She's such a beautiful singer. And she's so pretty. They wear these gorgeous black gowns that are full of sparkles. And we bought her matching black heels. Gorgeous. With some sparkle in them. Rhinestones. She's always the prettiest one. Yeah, she enjoys her singing. She does it nonstop. And her horseback riding. She loves the horses too. Yeah, she's, for those of you that don't know, she's 11. And she's in those terrible teenage years. It's almost like the terrible twos all over again. She's a little sassy. And, I'm constantly telling her, leave that stuff at school. Don't be bringing that home to me. How did I get pencil there? They're starting early in this generation, let me tell you. My kids that are, 30 and almost 33, were never like that. They'd think twice before they sassed. But little Holly is my miracle baby, and she's spoiled rotten. Anyways. Alright, what are we gonna put here? That's too much like that, sorry. That might look okay. I'm wondering if we should just do that. I have too many to choose from. Should we just do leaves? I don't like the white. I think we'll do this. Well, there's little white roses in there. I can't believe we're at a half an hour already. It's so much easier to upload videos that are at 30 minutes. That's another thing I miss is my camera. Let's do this. Yeah, I'm showing you ways to craft when you don't have products. So I certainly hope it helps somebody. You can still craft. You don't need all those fancy products. I am definitely learning that. And I like the button closure that I did. I would have never thought of that, I'm sure, if I had my crocodile and eyelets. All right, let's make sure. I've been staying in frame. I should be. So I'm going to be doing stitching here in a minute. I have thread in that my machine doesn't like because I think I probably got it at an estate sale. So it won't do a zigzag stitch. It does a weird zigzag stitch. Not right. I don't know why it has to be so picky. So there's that. You have the starts of it. So simple. So I'm going to turn you a little. If I can. Doesn't want to. There. So you can watch me. I'm just going to do a straight stitch. Oh, you know what I wanted to do? Before we do that, I don't want the square. I want these to be rounded. So to do that, I'm using this because I dare not freehand it. And I pray I get them even. So you're really getting a lesson in alternative items. All right, let's see if these are straight. And I should have done that before I put the paper down, to be honest. I did it right on my other one. Just not this one. Let's do a little bit of ink. And I realized you might not have been in frame. Sorry. But yeah, you want to do that before you lay the paper down and then measure the paper to it. So can you see? Awesome. So I'm just going to do a straight stitch. to go slower on this. I'm still getting used to this sewing machine. But I don't want to mess this curve up. Alright, so there we go. Even though it would look better, zigzag. Alright, let's figure out the inside. What do we want to do? This, I'm going to make into a flap. So we want to cut part of it off. Luckily, it has a line. We want to cover the back with some of that pretty rose paper. Oh, I need to move you back, don't I? How's that? Lots of inking. And I could have sewn this in, but I just wanted to get the sewing done. Let's see what we have. I have lots of scraps on this project. Here's our papers. That would cut too much off. Here we go. Maybe do the top. Yeah, let's do that. Cutting this straight. I can't see my mark. I still can't see it. That's funny. I know I made one. Let's get it right side up, Chris. I really do hate this bottle. It's just not. Look at what I have, because it is so small of a nozzle. This is the only thing I could find, and it's not clogged, that I could find. Isn't that funny? That's for a grill, to clean the grill. Well, it wasn't clogged. That was the only thing I could find that would fit in here for when it is clogged. All right, now we're going to use one of our scraps to make a hinge. That's not going to work. And so you just get a scrap piece of cardstock. Cardboard, or not cardboard, but some sort of cardstock. I'm using a piece from this file folder. You just fold it in half, get it even. It's almost even. There we go. But before that, I do want to stitch this. So I'm going to do this real quick. Maybe. So I put it on the stitch. Now I can't think of the name. And this is what it does. It does it perfect, zigzag. Does it perfect on the back side from the bobbin. But the top, it won't do it. And this is a Brother CP100X. And when I read, when it first did that, I freaked out. And when I read, I'm going to use Fabri-Tac. This is Beacon foam and poster adhesive, and it's the exact same thing as Fabi-Tac or 3-in-1. And it's sold at the Dollar Tree, if you can find it. So I'm putting the hinge on our flap, pressing that down for a second. You know, Fabri-Tac gives you a wiggle room. And that's why I wanted to use it, just in case the art glitter glue dries like instantly. I have glue all over my fingertips. All right. So we want to get that, but that right up to the edge. And this is why I said I could have put this on like the other one. I put this on before I stitched. And then stitched over it, and it held it, you know, extra stitching for reinforcement. But I didn't think to do it this time. That smells worse than Fabri-Tac though. Other than that, it's the exact same. Very strong. So this piece that we cut off, I'm going to use as a pocket. So let's just ink that up. Oh, and I hinged it the wrong way. Oh my goodness. Really? I wanted the rose on the inside. Do you think it's too late to fix it? See? All mistakes can be fixed. I knew there was a reason why I used the Fabri-Tac. Let's try this again. Oh my gosh, I'm sorry, I was concentrating. Boy, that was a lot of silence, wasn't it? I didn't want to mess it up again. Let's trim our threads. All right, now we'll try this pocket. And yeah, I recommend stitching after you put this on. I did it on my other one. I just not thinking. And that needs to be trimmed. Come on, Chris, get with the program. Too much silence, making me fall asleep. But what shall we talk about? I don't know. I'm running out of things. I probably should have done a part two, huh? All right, so there's that. And then I wanted to make a flap here. Like I did here. I don't have another one of those. And then a pocket. Maybe we'll just make a pocket. Since the video. Oh, geez. Shooting for an hour now. Let's do this one. Let's cut it right above the rose. And around these corners, put this little itty bitty rounder. And I'm not going to do a thumb hole because I don't want to cut into that rose. And again, this could have been put on and then stitched over. All right, let's do a belly band. Oh, it's gonna cover my rose. Oh, and that's another thing. That hinge should have been put on before the papers were put on. So let's put that over there. Boy, I'm really messing up this video, aren't I? I think it's because I'm being watched. I have a bunch of people over my shoulder. It's too much pressure, guys. We'll just put this here as a tuck. Cover some of that up. I did it on the right on the first one, I swear. I always seem to make a project before I film it, just for this reason. But I see it's not really doing me any good. All right. Oh, I lost my lid to my glue. Here it is. The button. Let's do the button. The button and the signatures. And I already have a thread and needle. So what I did for the button, You see where you want it, right in the center. And you're gonna poke your holes this way. So that your holes are ready for you. I already have this ready to go. And you can make it long or short. I did short. And I'm going to go through this a couple of times to make sure it stays on there tight. And this is a four-hole button. I'm only doing the two diagonal holes. You don't need to do all four. There we go. Do a couple of knots. Alright. Let me put a knot. I always keep a knot in here. That way I know it's ready to go. Alright, so let's see if we have enough of this. Nope, we don't, do we? Let's grab something else. Let's grab this since it was right there. And just tie that into a knot. That one's a little blockier. Very simple, guys. You can use anything. So we got our, and I'm leaving that because I think it's cute with the two. And let's do a signature. I have some papers, probably not enough, but 2, 3, 4. Maybe we should put one of these rose ones in the center. Even though it's white on the other side. Let's just do that. Let's just do that. Do that so we can call this done. I hope that you guys benefited from the video. Yeah, I'm about out of coffee dyed paper. I definitely need to take the time and make some more. I have cheesecloth that needs to be dyed too. I like this better. I like that side better for the first page. I'm going to leave that white edge just so I don't take any more of your time. And you could definitely fit a lot more pages in here. Alright, let's get my needle. And I'm not going to have any dangles, so I'm just going to go twice. And this is some wax thread, some very thick wax thread. which doesn't need to be so thick, but, and I don't even need to use wax thread because there's not that many pages in here. I lost my hole there. In the center, or out the center, in the top, out the bottom, I'm struggling, guys, I'm rushing now. Thread is very thick. All right, and then back in the center. If I can find the hole. Come up on the other side of your center line. Pull that tight. Tie it a couple of times, and you want to do right over left and then left over right. Trim, and you are good to go. Perfect. Fill it up. Decorate it if you want some more. I think it's decorated enough with all of these roses. And there you go. So thanks for joining me today, guys. I really appreciate your support of my channel. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you have not subscribed, I would really appreciate it if you would. I will see you next time. Thanks, guys.